Hello, this is Solar PVT once again from Nairobi, from Kenya, from Rest for Africa event. And now we are together with Guido Mivis, who is working for Africa for LTI RE Energy. And he brought some good news, actually, not from Kenya, but from other countries. So maybe, Guido, first, I would like to ask you, what is your feedback about the event? How do you like it?
Oh, it's a very nice event, and there has to be more events like this in the African countries, because there are so much opportunities in the African countries here, so we need to do this more. It's really good.
You spent last month in Nigeria, yes? So what's happening actually in Nigeria?
So in Nigeria, the last 2 months, they have signed around 1 gigawatt of PPAs. We are busy now with 100 megawatt projects. Normally, construction will start in January. So that is really good news. And we will have also another 200 megawatt in the next coming 6 to 7 months also.
That is great. So it means that also Nigeria is starting to really deploy solar, yes?
Absolutely. In Nigeria, there are a lot of opportunities. And I think now in the next coming years, you will see that there will be a lot of renewable energy projects coming out, mainly in the northern part of the country.
So you are, besides Nigeria, also active in other countries, yes, like South Africa and other countries. So how do you see, from your point of view, which are the most promising markets?
Yes, I think the most promising markets are for sure Nigeria, Kenya, Ethiopia, Senegal, all the ECOWAS countries, let us say the ECOWAS countries. Also in South Africa, there are still opportunities, but it's stuck a little bit in South Africa, but I think it will pick up in the next coming years, it will pick up again, because also there they still need a lot of solar projects, I'm quite sure of
but
it.
It's going to be more like on the governmental level or local levels or private investors? How do you see that?
So I think in South Africa it will be more in the next future on the private level. So I think more and more also the municipalities starting to have constructions. So I think it will be more on that side. The government will still have the bidding rounds that will be still on. But the main project, I think, will come of the private projects in South Africa.
And Guido, you are also, let's say, working very closely with investors. And how do you see their perseverance of investment in renewable energies?
So I think the investors are still more and more keen to invest in Africa. They are sure now that Africa is the continent to be on for the next 5 to 10 years, because there are so much opportunities there. So in the beginning, they were a little bit hesitating to come to Africa. There were already a lot of investors in South Africa, but now it starts also when I see that the investors are very keen to come to Nigeria, Kenya, and all the other African countries. So I think the future looks nice.
And what would be your advice actually to Rest for Africa, for the organization, for the next activities, what they should do in practice?
I think they have to do it in more countries. It's great to bring all the people together and discuss everything, bring the investors together, bring the people who do the constructions, everybody together, and also the government. I think that is they did a great job by organizing this.
And you're going to attend also this event, yeah?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, thank you so much, Guido. That was Solar PVTV together with Guido Mivis, who is working for LTI RE Energy in Africa, bringing some good news from different countries and hoping that there is a solar future here in Africa. Thanks for watching.
Thank you.